Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, what was happening around 42,000 years ago? Well, for starters, we have evidence that there was some pretty advanced deep sea fishing happening over in East Timor, as there were boats that were making the crossing all the way over to Australia, and evidence of deep sea fishing for things like tuna. And you wonder, why is that important to astronomy? And that's because the object we're going to look for has light that has traveled for 42,000 years. So back when early humans were making those particular advances, the light from this object left and is reaching our eyes now. That's how long this has taken. So what we're going to do is look below Orion. And if you've been following my Twitter or Facebook feeds, you'll have noticed that I have focused a little bit on the constellation of Lepus the Hare, and it is right below Orion right here. You can see how there's the hare shapes, kind of got the ears going up this way and the tail out that way. So that's supposed to be the hare. If you look at the constellation art, you can see a little bit better representation of how that might appear if you're supposed to be looking at it in the sky. And those stars aren't too terribly dim. There's actually some second, third magnitude stars there. We just tend to overlook it because Orion has so many bright stars and it's such a great shape of a constellation. But if we look just below where Rigel and Safe are at the bottom part of the constellation, we can find the rabbit here. Now, to find this particular object, we're going to look for two of the brightest stars in the rabbit. So here's Safe right up there, and we're going to look kind of below there and look for this star, Arneb, which is just below second magnitude. It's a very high third magnitude star at 2.55. And then below that, not too many degrees away, is Nihal Beta Leporis, which is a 2.8 magnitude star. So these are going to be similar in brightness. They're only a third of a magnitude difference. And as you can see from the distance here, they're only about 3 degrees apart. So they will be less than your fingers held at arm's length in the Boy Scout symbol like this, because that would be 5 degrees. So 3 degrees is definitely less than that. This distance here from Safe down to Arneb, that's about not quite 10 degrees. So fist held at arm's length distance away, just so you have some idea of how far away you want to be looking for that. So to find the object we're looking for, we're going to just follow a line from Arneb through Nihal like this, and then keep going down to this star right here, which is a fifth magnitude star. So 7 degrees is our total distance from Arneb to that star. So that's really a finder scope field of view, and we'll look at that, how that would look in a finder scope field here in just a moment. And the object we're looking for is Messier 79. A globular cluster that you want to try to look for when everything is on the meridian. The meridian is that line that goes from south all the way to north overhead, and we'll show you where that's at. If you look in the markings right there, that's the meridian. And as you can see, we've got Orion and the hare, Lepus, pretty close to that. So 3 to 4 hours after sunset at this time of year is a good time to look. You can really look on either side of it between 3 and 4 hours, and you'll have a pretty good opportunity to be able to find M79. So when we zoom in on the area, we're going to center those, and then we'll bring up what a binocular's field of view would be. That's what binoculars would show. Here's Arneb way up here. There's Nihal. So you'll have both of those easily within your field of view. You can just kind of aim that general direction, get both those, then center Nihal, and then just take that line and just keep bringing it down in this direction, and you can see how that fifth magnitude star will show up in your field of view. You want to kind of center that one, and you're going to go back just a little bit because M79 is right over here. There's a ninth magnitude star there, and there's another ninth magnitude star there, and M79 is right in between there. I actually have to pull up the search window to make it pop up, but that's exactly where it's at. And that distance is just a degree away. So actually less than that, half a degree. Half a degree from that star. So you can probably even have it in the field of view if you kind of center it, but you want to have that star just outside of your crosshairs is probably going to be your best opportunity. And then use wide, long focal length to start, and then you can start bumping that up. And when we do bump that up, what do we see? But a nice bright field of view. Here's your ninth magnitude stars. Let me take the measuring tool out of the way. There's your 1/9 magnitude star on this side. There's your other one on this side. This one is just a bit brighter. It's an 8.8 magnitude. This one is a 9.4. So they're about a half of a magnitude apart from each other. But the globular cluster itself, 42,000 light years away, so long way off, and that light's traveled a long way to get to your eye. It's also, although it's 8.5 magnitude, which might seem kind of bright, look at the surface brightness. It's 13.2, so it's going to look a little bit dim. Employ some of those good deep sky type of techniques, like covering your eyes, put a towel over your head, a dark towel ideally, to help block any extraneous light. You can use an eye patch. They're like $3, $4, $5 at a drugstore. You can cover one eye, and then when you're ready to actually use that, put the eye patch on the eye that you're going to use to actually look for M79, and then when you're ready to look at it after about 20-30 minutes of having that on, your eye will really dark adapted. And so that's a great opportunity to be able to see more of the stars that are coming from that light 42,000 light years away. But that's how you find Messier 79 in Lepus the Hare. Not too difficult. For those of you well to the north, you might have some difficulty just because the height of that off the horizon is not terribly high. As we can see azimuth-wise, that's up at 25 degrees. So if you're I'm looking at this from about 40 degrees north latitude. So if you're 55, that's only going to be 10 degrees off your horizon. You'll be looking through a lot more atmosphere. You'll need some darker skies, and you really want to look at when it's right there within a few degrees of the meridian. So it's at its highest point. But that's how you can find Messier 79 in the night sky for this particular time of the year. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.